Alrighty, y'all. Welcome to the Dirt Road Grocery Store. So you want to buy a turkey shotgun. Which one is the best? Too long didn't watch. Break action 20 gauge with a tang safety and a red dot sight. If you're more interested and want to decide for yourself, I'll be glad to maybe guide you through a little bit. First thing we want to talk about is gauge. We want to talk about gauge because with modern turkey ammunition,
I shall go for it.
Modern turkey ammunition, you have a lot of choices. You can even kill one with a 410. You might want to choose a 410 because it doesn't weigh very much. This gun is 3.3 pounds. It's my favorite one to carry, obviously. And according to the targets, it'll kill one to 50 yards. According to my practice, it'll kill one to about 38. If you want something lightweight, but you want a little more wider pattern, say, because the pattern of a 410 is necessarily narrow because it doesn't have so many pellets, you can go with a 20 gauge. 20 gauge will do everything with modern turkey loads, everything the old 3.5 inch 12 gauge will do, and then some. That's if you're using high density tungsten shot. Now, if you don't need to kill them that far, maybe you're hunting over decoys at 20 yards, maybe you just want to use your old dove gun. This 12 gauge, it make one flop at 35 yards, and it do that with a good dove load. A cheap dove load, 20 yards, no problem. And then, of course, if you just hate turkeys a whole lot and want to kill one as far as you can, you might want to go with a dedicated 12 gauge. A heavy load of that high-density tungsten will kill a turkey at 80 and 90 yards. I don't see the point in it, but maybe you're not very good at hunting. So we've covered gauge. Now we want to cover sights. It depends entirely.
That's a good boy.
It depends entirely on how good your eyeballs are. Now you wouldn't put sights on your dove gun if you were going to use it. But if you're using a very tightly choked gun, you're really going to need a red dot sight. These mini reflex sights are very good and surprisingly dependable. I've been using them for years now and haven't had any trouble yet, knock on wood. But the very best sights you can use, if your eyes are good enough, is just a regular old bead sight. Like here, you won't hardly break one of those, will you? You could knock a red dot sight off. If you had fiber optic sights mounted on the rib, those could be knocked off alignment. So if you've just got a bead and your eyes are good enough to use it, that's fine. Just remember, at close range, turkey loads and turkey chokes are very tight. And if you're not lined up right, you have to miss. Now, anybody who's turkey hunted very long probably has a missing story. I know I've got one. Or six.
Barrel length.
Old barrel length. People like short barrels on a turkey gun. People like a short barrel on a turkey gun because they have imagination. And when they're not turkey hunting, sitting around thinking, they're worried about bumping stuff with the old barrel there. And if you're watching the video looking for advice on getting a turkey gun, then you probably don't turkey hunt as much as I do. This is my main turkey gun, has been for some years, got a 28 inch barrel plus extended choke. Barrel length is not a problem. I've never had trouble hitting stuff when I'm trying to get on the turkey. Short barrel length has been a problem because it'll blow your eardrums out. The shorter these barrels get, and this is 20 inches plus choke, this ported choke, very loud, extremely loud. And I haven't figured out a good way to wear hearing protection while turkey hunting. The reason I have this old gun is sentimental value. I've killed a pile of turkeys with it before I got sense. And it's my backup nowadays. Safety location. Now, if you don't turkey hunt very much, or you hunt out of a blind over decoys, or you're coming to turkey hunt late in life when you just type safety so much, that's all you can stand. Then maybe you don't want to change from that. Because in the heat of the moment is when your muscle memory takes over and you have to make a mistake. I don't dirty hunt with this gun, but if I did, I imagine I'd be trying to push the safety up here and just down here. I've done it other kinds of hunting. That's why I only use this for wing shooting. Every other kind of hunting I do, I use a different type of safety.
Now, he's a good boy.
Now, let's go over the types of safeties and how they relate to turkey hunting. A safety located up here is easily brushed off. It's very good for wing shooting because it's right there and it's natural. But if you're going to go walking around, it's very easily brushed off on the clothes. I took it rabbit hunting one time and it scared me because I found it brushed off safety. Why I don't like to take it any other kind of hunting except for doves or ducks. Now, you'll have a push button safety back here. It's very common. You'll probably be used to that one. A lot of people have that one. The reason it's put back here is it's cheap to manufacture. It's a lot cheaper than that one. And when you're making a ton of guns, that matters. However, it is slightly more protected. Not entirely, but it's slightly more protected. It's still apt to be brushed off, but it's not going to happen anywhere near so much as the front of the trigger guard. If you use one front trigger guard, you want to check it pretty often. Back of the trigger guard, you also want to check it. Now, the problem for turkey hunting with either one of those safeties, even though this one back here is probably all right, because it's much less likely to be brushed off, when you're doing this, you can't see it. And when you're turkey hunting, what happens a lot of times, you have it propped up on your knee. Oh, he's coming. I know he's coming now. You ease that safety off nice and quiet. Don't say as quiet as you'd like. Safety off on him, he didn't come. I gotta move. So I get up and I move, but I can't see that safety. In the heat of the moment, you're liable to forget. That's why I would never recommend you use one of these unless you're disabled by many years of practice and being able to use any other kind. But be realistic, if your shotgun has a trigger guard safety, you've been using it for 40 years, you have no intention of ever giving that gun up, don't change. Just make the adjustments to make sure and train yourself to constantly check that safety. Now, a hammer on a gun is a safety, and it's up top where you can see it, just like this old tang safety up here. Old tang safety here, you're looking at it. Is the gobbler coming in? Did I take the safety off? Oh no, I didn't. So you see it, you have that direct feedback and you can make decisions. Also, it's kind of hidden behind the gun. See how easy it was to take it off? And it's very easy from a firing position to take it off silently, whereas these safe push button safeties tend to make a click, even if you try real hard to take them off. You can mash down on it, get it off quiet, you can guide it forward, both fingers get off quiet. They don't brush off. It's on the side of the gun, you're not getting these forces. It's either on or off. You leave it there, it stays there. Assuming it's in good operating order. These have, see, it clicks there, mash down on it, silent. Ease it forward, silent. So the best safety style on a turkey gun is to have a hammer with a hammer block in it or tang. Action.
That's a good boy.
He's a buck.
He's a buck.
The action on the gun, this is my favorite one to carry around. And this is a single shot. I don't feel hampered by that. But I can tell you right now, I don't carry it until I've already killed one in the season. My first bird of the season is going to be killed with this one, because it's got a second shot. I don't make a practice of killing two turkeys at once. I have none, but I have missed a turkey I wanted very badly to kill in the second barrel safety thing. repeater of some kind. Automatic or a double barrel. Pump action ain't too bad. Oh, and for y'all saying, oh wait, that's a semi-automatic. We don't get automatic full autos. There are semi-autos, but automatics, where I come from anywhere. Maybe y'all Yankees ain't worried about stuff like that. That's automatic. The differences in them is for an automatic, you have to make sure it's seated. When you're at the truck, you're going to slingshot it. Better ride home hard. You get out there in the woods, you got to ease it. And the problem is the extractor on these things has got to go over the rim of the cartridge. And you got to push it forward kind of hard to get it to seat. And it tends to go click. You can't have that turkey hunting. Turkeys have excellent hearing. If you make a noise, they hear it. They may not do anything about it. They may leave the country. But they do hear everything. So, automatic's not the best because of action. Now, you may say, well, I'm going to slingshot it at the truck. That'll be fine. I'm going to get me an upgraded spring in the stock. I don't have to worry about that old Benelli click. But what if you got to cross the creek? You got to unload your gun. You got to run the action. Maybe you got to cross the creek tight to that goblin. And you don't want him to hear you because he's going to shut down on you. Well, automatic's out the store. Pump action about the same. I was hunting with a fellow one time. That's pretty quiet. It ain't silent. You can cross the creek. And that's pretty quiet. You probably get away with that. I was hunting with a fellow one time. No, he did. Shut down. I had a target 200 yards. We're going to make the last move. And I was going to call him up in his lap. That's it. So pump action, a well-worn one, you might get away with quiet enough. What really works is a brake action. And the way you do that is you hold the lever, close the gun, that doesn't make any noise. Then cinch it back. I don't know how many years I've been doing that, but it works with a brake action. It is the best because of safety. Need to cross an obstacle, climb a bank on the creek, wade through a swamp, anything where you might step off and fall with a loaded gun, you need to unload. Quiet as a mouse. So far we have covered gauge, whatever you want. Just be advised that the sub gauges have smaller patterns. Well, 410s do. 20 gauge, good enough. 12 gauge, plenty enough. So if you go down to 410, be aware you have to have a smaller pattern. It's easier to miss with. Sights, bead is the best. If you wear Coke bottles, you need a red dot. Some people use scopes. Barrel length, longer is quieter. Shorter doesn't matter. Safety, tang or hammer. Action, brake action is the best. You can probably get by with the pump, semi-auto, unless you hunt in the desert with no fences. And camo. Well, you can probably tell I don't care about camouflage. When I turkey hunt, most of the time, the reason this is camouflage is because I had it and I needed something to keep this from sliding up the barrel. If that didn't slide up the barrel, it wouldn't be on there. So there would be no camouflage on it. It's not shiny, which is probably important, but it's camo enough. And at long distances, camouflage patterns just look like one color, whereas this looks like multiple colors. So I guess in a sense it is camouflage. But I have to tell you the truth, camo doesn't matter, because if the turkey is close enough to you to see whether or not you're wearing camouflage, you need to be dead. And further, you need to be sitting in the shade. If you were sitting in the shade and not moving, he ain't gonna see you. I don't even wear a mask when I turkey hunt. I call him to me. Well, I'm sitting in the wide open some of the time, and there's nothing between me and the turkey and air. Camo's not important, for your gun at least. I do wear full camouflage otherwise. But I'm starting to suspect I don't even need that. The trick to it is if it's not shiny, looking unnatural, and it's not hiding behind something about ready to jump out to him, a turkey's just not wired to notice it. They ain't smart. You got a brain about the size of your thumb. So that's turkey guns for you. And we said, no camo necessary, just not shiny. Red dot sight's pretty nice, but a bead if you can stand it. Break action will pump. 12 gauge if you shoot at very short range and can get by with dove loads. Or if you're going special to turkey loads, whatever you want. I like this 14.
You like this 14?
Hmm. You don't care, do you? As long as it kills it. Well, that was the Dirt Road Grocery Store, the best turkey shotgun. Y'all enjoy it.
Steve,
you ain't staying. Why you don't stay, Buzz? Come on back. Come on. How we gonna kill turkeys if you don't stay? Lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Lie down. That's your good boy. You can't get it. You can't get it. You can't have it. No. You can't have it. Stay. Stay. You gonna try to get that thing? You can't smell it. You can smell it. You stay. Stay now.
Stay. Keep on the sunny side.